Judge Jeanine. And joining me now with reaction to my opening statement and all the breaking news, Doctor of Dental Surgery and Texas Congressman Brian Babin and Florida Congressman Ron DeSantis. All right, guys, thank you both for being here. I'm going to start with Congressman Babin. All right, Congressman, why do we rely on other countries for the development of Molly 99?
Mainly because we have stopped manufacturing nuclear weapons because of an agreement we did back in the 80s with the Soviet Union, and so we are no longer creating weapons, and quite frankly, we're dependent upon a lot of nations around the world for our radioisotopes that we use, and these radioisotopes are extremely important for the manufacture of these various isotopes that are used in the practice of medicine and diagnosing and treating diseases such as cancer and saving lives. And as you said earlier, there are 40 million procedures a year done with nuclear medicine, and so it's very, very important that we not be dependent upon foreign nations, especially Russia, for these isotopes.
And Dr. Babin, Congressman Babin, if you could tell my viewers what would Molly 99, what is nuclear imaging? When they go for what kind of test, would this be relevant or would this be used?
Well, they're like I said, there are 40 million procedures a year, and many of them are specific for certain organs in the body, whether it's your heart, your thyroid, or muscular diseases or bones, and these isotopes are man-made. In fact, all of them are man-made, and they're very specific for these for their task at hand, and they save lives. I can't overemphasize that. They are so much better than the old traditional X-rays, our PET scans, our CT scans. I mean, there's so many of these different types of tests that have advanced the medical fields so much in saving American lives. So we can't be dependent upon other nations to give us this these isotopes.
All right, and Congressman DeSantis, I'll go to you. Given the corruption case that is underlying that Uranium One deal, and you know the news that's been broken in the last few days about that deal, why would there be an Iranian deal where $150 billion then goes to Iran, where we invest in them to be able to create the medical isotopes so we can then buy it back? So we're giving uranium or selling it to Russia. Obama administration approves it. And then we're dealing with Iran, giving them $150 billion so that we can then buy the isotopes from them.
And that violates a 2012 law that was actually enacted by Congress to try to address the problem of us having to import this, the uranium underlying these tests. And the Iran deal was never passed by Congress. It was never ratified as a treaty. It was basically Obama making an executive agreement, obviously front-loading hundreds of billions of dollars in benefits to a terror-financing state. But he was doing that unilaterally, and you cannot violate existing law. Right. So that's a huge issue in and of itself. And then, oh, by the way, with the Clinton uranium deal, we were told, as you mentioned, Judge, in your open, oh, yeah, so Russia has 20%. They're not allowed to export it because they didn't have an exporting license. And while that is technically true, what we've now found out was that that uranium was sent outside the United States. They did it very underhandedly.
You know,
there were a lot of indirect ways to do it, but that was exported.
Congressman, do we know once that stuff was exported and they used trucking to get it to Canada, do we know where it went from Canada? And by the way, to my viewers, we're on the screen, we're waiting for the president and Air Force One to land, I believe, and that's why that screen is up. But Congressman DeSantis, do we know that?
Well, we definitely know that it went to Europe. We believe it went to Asia, and we're working on trying to figure out whether it did in fact end up in the hands of a rogue regime like Iran. We haven't been able to substantiate that yet, but we have some indications that may have happened. We're working on that. Hopefully we'll be able to substantiate that soon, one way or another.
And in that regard, your committee, and we appreciate your coming back on Justice, you've indicated that you're starting hearings on this whole thing. You've got some breaking news for us. That informant on that underlying criminal case that was in the Rod Rosenstein's office, that gag order has been lifted. What do you expect to hear in the next few weeks?
So we are getting all of the documents. He compiled all kind of documents from his time as an informant. So we're getting all of those documents. We've already gotten leads based on some of the information in there. We're going to be bringing him in within the next couple of weeks. He's going to be interviewed mostly behind the scenes so that we can tease out all the information. And then it's going to require us to follow some of these leads. I think we will eventually do hearings, but I think there's just so much information that we're now going to have access to for the first time in years that's going to take us some time to really go through all that, because there's a lot of different moving parts in this. A lot of it's corrupt, but there are a bunch of different parts.
Well, and clearly the attorney for the informant who was gagged is calling for a special counsel, as is Senator Grassley, and I assume you believe that to be the case as well?
Well, if Jeff Sessions has taken the position and he's going to recuse on anything involving the Clintons, then obviously he would not be able to handle this. But neither could his deputy Rosenstein, for exactly the reason you mentioned. Rosenstein was involved in handling the McCarran prosecution. And I think there's some questions about how these cases were disposed of. So I think because of Sessions' position, Rosenstein's involvement, I do think it would be appropriate to have a special counsel outside the normal chain.
All right. And Congressman Babb and I assume that members of Congress are going to be doing everything they can to comply with the Medical Isotopes Act so we can start developing these isotopes and the key to identifying and treating some major diseases here in the United States.
Department of Energy has already started with millions of dollars worth of grants to various American institutions so that we can begin to do this.
Well, let's hope so, because I haven't heard of any that are actually developing. Anyway, Congressman Babin, Congressman DeSantis, thanks so much for being with us tonight. And a reminder, we are very close to